Hey everyone, welcome back. Johnny B here with Devslopes.com, and we have some more Mapbox fun for you. This is the current state of our app. We are able to see the user's location. But now we want to make it so that when we tap on the map, we are able to drop a marker, and we also want to add in our start navigation button. So let's get to it. I'm going to open up the activity main.xml and jump into our design pane. And we are going to just drop in a button. So with a button selected, I'm going to drag it into the constraint layout. And then I'm going to grab map view and move it above the button. Then with the button selected, I'm going to add constraints to the right, to the left, and to the bottom. Then I'm going to change the constraint type to match constraint in the layout width. And then I'm going to add margin of 24 to each of the sides. I'm going to give it an ID of start button. And then down here in the text color, I'm going to change it to project Mapbox gray light. There we go. And then let's jump into our text so we can make sure that the constraints are correct. Make sure that these are constrained to the parent and not to the map view for these three right here. And for our text, we can say start navigating. And I'm going to go ahead and accept the option to extract this as a string resource and say OK. And that should be good for our button. Oh, one more thing. We want it to be disabled by default. So I'm going to come into its more attributes and search for enabled. And I'm going to click twice to uncheck it. OK. So now that button is disabled when we start out. All right, so let's go ahead and jump back into our main activity. And we need to know when the map is clicked on. So we need to add another listener, an interface here. And the interface that we want is OnMapClickListener. And then we are going to need to implement its method. So I'm going to come down here below the set camera position, and we want OnMapClick. And from that, we get a point. So whenever we tap, we are getting the point from that location. We are getting its latitude and longitude. So let's talk about real quick what we want to happen when we tap. We are going to be setting a destination position where the pin is, and we are also going to be setting our origin position as well as the destination marker. So we're going to need a few new variables. So let's come back up here to the top here, and here under origin location, I'm going to say private, and we are going to have a point. Now make sure that you import the com.mapbox.geojson point, okay? So we have a point, and this is going to be origin position. And let me fix that typo real quick. There we go, origin position. Then we have a second point, which is going to be the destination position. And these points are going to be used later when we draw our route on top of the map view. And then we are also going to need our marker. So I'm going to say private of type marker. And we're going to call this destination marker. All right, and before I forget, in the onMap ready, we need to set our listener. So I'm going to say map dot add onMap click listener and this. We're also going to need a variable for our button, our start button. So I'm going to say private button, and we're going to call it start button. And it looks like I need to import this, Alt Enter to import. And then here in onCreate, let's go ahead and add our onClickListener. So I'm going to say start button.set onClickListener, new view.onClickListener. And we're going to leave this for now. This is what we're going to work on in the next couple of lessons, launch navigation UI. All right, so coming back down to our onMapClick. So whenever we tap on our map, we get the point. And we want to drop a marker wherever we tap. Okay, so we are going to say destination marker is equal to map.addMarker. And then we are going to pass in some marker options. We're going to say new marker options. And we are going to add.position. And we're going to pass into it the point that we have tapped on. Now with these marker options, you can add things like a title or a snippet or even change the default icon for that marker. But for right now, we're just going to set the position. And then we are also going to set the destination position. And we are going to set that equal to point dot from Langlat. And we are going to get that longitude and latitude from the point. So point dot get longitude, and then point dot get latitude. And then we're also going to set the origin position from doing it the same way, point dot from Langlat. But this is going to come from our origin location. So origin location dot get longitude, and the origin location dot get latitude. And finally, we are going to enable our button. So I'm going to say start button dot set enabled true, and start button dot set background resource r dot color, color dot mapbox blue. Speaking of the button, I think I forgot to bind it. So let's jump up here and sure enough, we need to say start button is equal to find view by ID r dot ID dot start, start button. And this map view right there, that's a little bit redundant. And there we go. All right, so that should do it. Let's go ahead and run this and see if we can drop some markers. All right, so I'm gonna tap on my device and, there we go. So the button turned blue once we added a marker, and we are able to add markers wherever we tap. So that is pretty cool. All right, so this isn't quite the desired behavior that we want, though. We don't want to have multiple markers when we're trying to get somewhere. So coming back down here to our on map click, first we are going to just do a check to see if there is an existing marker, and if there is, we're going to remove it. So I'm going to say if destination marker does not equal null, so if there is one, then we're just going to remove it. So I'm going to say map.remove marker and pass in destination marker. And let's go ahead and run that one more time to make sure it's what we expect. All right, so I'm going to tap, the button becomes enabled, we can click on it. If I tap somewhere else, the previous one disappears and a new one is added. Perfect. All right, so there we go. We're gonna finish up this lesson here. We are able to add markers. We can detect when the user has tapped on the map. In the next lessons, we are going to go over actually adding the route overlay so you can see the route on the map view. And then when we click on the start navigating button, make it so that we get that navigation UI with the turn-by-turn directions, all right? So hope you're excited for that, and I'll see you in the next ones.